Hey everybody, OVW here. This tutorial will be a tad bit different because I forgot my tripod at my other spot. So, if the camera is a little shaky, that's because Mini O.V.W is holding it. We'll either go that route or I'll be just doing it right in front of here, which is going to be maybe hard for you to understand, but I'll kind of talk it out as I do it so you can understand it. I'm going to be using these two colors, which is loops and threads, and I'm using a lavender and a green, and I'm going to stripe it, like I said. we're going to originally do the hat in an H-hook, and that's usually between a 19 to 21 size head, and then you will go up to a I-hook for a larger size head, mainly close to 22 to 20. Four, and if your head is bigger than a 24 inch to, let's say, 26, I would say go up to a J. So we're going to originally start out with the H hook. So we're going to see how this going to work out with Nyasia holding the camera. And if it gets too shaky, then I'll be doing the tutorials straightforward here and just trying to show you in the camera what I've done, okay? So we're going to try it out, and this is just a regular cap with a brim, and I'm going to be doing the brim on this video as well, because I guess my last brim tutorial was kind of dark, and I was using a black yarn, so it was hard for you guys to see. So I have gotten plenty of requests, so this can be a unisex hat. Whatever colors you choose, it could be for male or female. And if you want to even go smaller than a 21 or 19 size inch hat, you would drop the hook size. Like I've did toddler size for my nephew, and I used a G hook. So you'll drop the size now as the size you need it. So we're going to use these two, and we're going to stripe them. So if you're ready, get your hook. Your size H, I, J hook, or your G hook, whichever size hat you're doing, and your yarn, two colors if you're going to stripe it, one color, or if you want to use three colors, doesn't matter, and let's get started. Okay, so let's get started. You're going to do your basic slip knot here. All right, we're going to chain five, one, two, 3, 4, 5, do a slip stitch into the first single crochet. All right, chain one. Now you're going to do 10 single crochets into the ring. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Continue doing 5 more single crochets into the ring, and I'll meet you at the end. All right, so I did 9 single crochets. I'm going to do my last one, and this is when I'm going to get my second color, which is the green here. So I'm going to not finish my single crochet, but I'm going to finish it off with the green. All right. And now I'm going to slip stitch into the first single crochet here. And I'm going to slip it with my green. Okay. So you're going to drop your purple. You're going to drop the purple or your first color. Drop that down. And you're going to continue with your second color as you're crocheting over your tail. So for round two, you're going to chain one. And you're going to do a single crochet into the same stitch you slipped. And you're going to do 2 single crochets in each stitch all the way around. 1, 2, 1, 2, and as you see, I'm crocheting over my tail. 1, 2. So continue doing 2 single crochets in each stitch, and I'll meet you at the end when we're gonna pick up our first color again. Okay, so I have my last stitch here to do. Going to do 1 single crochet, and now my next one, but I'm going to switch to my new color. So I'm going to drop the green, pick it back up
my first color, wrap it around and pull through. And now I'm going to slip stitch at the beginning, single crochet. All right, so now we're ready to start our new color. So we're going to chain one. All right, so we're now ready for round three. You're going to do a single crochet into the same stitch you slip. One single crochet into the next. Two in the next. One, two. One single crochet in the next. Two in the next. One, two. One single crochet in the next. Two in the next. One, two. So you're going to go single, double, single, double. So single and then double. One, two. So keep going single and then two in the next all the way around. And I'll meet you at the end when we're going to drop our first color and pick back up the second. All right, so we are ending row three. So I'm going to have one last stitch here. I did a single, so now I have to do a double, one. And so when I do the last one here, I'm going to be dropping my first color and picking back up the second, wrap around and pull through. Here's the key, so you don't have that shift in your change coloring. You want it to be continuing all the way around. You have to change the color with the last single crochet you do. And then you slip stitch into the first single crochet and pull it. And you're ready for row four. So row four, you're going to chain one. And you're going to do a single crochet in the next stitch. A single crochet in the next. And then double in the next. One, two. So you're going to go single, single, double, single, single, double. So single, single, and then double. One, two, single, single, and then double. One, two. So you're going to continue single, single, double, all the way around, and I'll meet you at the last stitch where we'll change colors again. Okay, so we're finishing up row four. I'm going to do my last two stitches in the same stitch. Now I'm going to change to my new color, dropping the second color and picking back up the first. All right. Now we're going to slip stitch into the first single crochet and chain one, and you're ready for row five. Okay, so we're going to go single crochet in the same stitch you slip, a single crochet in the next three stitches, one, two, three, double in the next, one, two, single crochet in the next three stitches, one, two, three, double in the next, one, two, single crochet in the next three, one, two, three, double in the next, one, two. So continue doing single crochet in the next three stitches, double in the next, and I will meet you at the last stitch when we'll change our color again. All right, so we are at the end of row five. You're going to just do a single crochet. Remember, getting ready to change the color, drop the purple, pick up the green, and slip it through. Go to the first single crochet, pull through, and you're ready for row six. You're going to chain one, and you're going to do a single crochet into the same stitch you slip, and then a single crochet in each stitch all the way around. So we're just going to do a single crochet in each stitch all the way around. So continue doing that all the way around, and I'll meet you at the end. All right, so we are at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. End of row six, do a single crochet. Remember, we're changing the color. Drop the green, pick up the purple. All right, slip stitch into the first. All right, so we're ready for row seven, and chain one. You're going to do a single crochet in the same stitch you slipped, a single crochet in the next four stitches, one, two, three, four, double in the next, one, two, single crochet in the next four stitches, one, two, three, four, double in the next, one, two, single, next four, one, two, three, four, double in the next, one, two. So continue doing that, single in the next four, doubling in the next, and I'll meet you at the end.
All right, so we're at the end of row seven. You're going to do a single crochet, changing your color, dropping it, picking up your next color, pull it through to complete the single crochet. That is the key in changing colors in rows. Slip into the first, chain one, you're ready for row eight. Okay, so for row eight, you're going to do a single crochet once again into the same stitch you slipped. You're going to do a single crochet into the next five stitches. One, two, three, four, five, and you're going to double in the next. One, two, single crochet in the next five stitches. One, two, three, four, five, double in the next. One, two. So continuing that, single crochet in the next five stitches, doubling in the next stitch all the way around, and I'll meet you at the
end. All right, so ending 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, row 8, going to do a single crochet, pull up, change your color, wrap around and pull through, and slip stitch into the first single crochet. All right, so for row 9 and 10, you're going to chain one. You're going to do a single crochet into the next stitch, and then a single crochet into each stitch all the way around for row 9 and row 10. You're going to do the same thing. Remember, changing your color at the end of row 9 back to your next color. All right, and you're going to do a single crochet all the way around. So I'm going to go ahead and finish row 9 and then continue on doing row 10, and I'll meet you at the end of row 10 doing a single crochet all the way around.
Okay, so I'm at the end of row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'm going to do my last single crochet, switching back to my color. Slip stitch. Okay. And then you're going to slip stitch into the first single crochet. You're ready for row 11. So you're going to chain one. You're going to do a single crochet into the very same stitch you slipped. Now you're going to do a single crochet in the next six single crochets. And then you're going to double in the next. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and then double. One, two, and then one. Let me untangle my yarn here. So you're going to single crochet in the next six. That was one, two, three, four, five, six, and now double in the next. One, two. One single crochet in the next six. One, two, three, four, five, six, and double in the next. One, two. So continue doing a single crochet in the next six stitches and then doubling in the next. All the way around, continue to repeat that process, and I'll meet you at the end. Okay, so the end of row 11, you're going to do a single crochet, switching back to your other color, slip stitching in the first single crochet, pull through. Now you're ready for row 12. which is basically going to be a single crochet all the way around, starting at the same stitch you slipped. So you're going to do a single crochet in each stitch all the way around. So continue doing that, single crochet all the way around, and I'll meet you at the end. All right, so we are at the end of row 12, I believe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yes, end of round 12. So single crochet, remember, switching colors, slipping, and you're ready for row 13, chain 1. So your hat should be curving now. All right, so we're at row, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We're at row 13 now. So for row 13, all the way till you get to the necessary length that you need for your hat, you're just going to do a single crochet in the same stitch you slipped, and then a single crochet in each stitch all the way around. I usually go about 23 to 26 rows. So I'm going to continue on till I get to my necessary length, starting from row 13, going all the way to about row 23, and then I'll come back. So remember, do a single crochet in the same stitch you slipped, and a single crochet going all the way around for each row. Remember, switching colors at your last single crochet of the row, and chain one at the beginning of each row. So we're now at row 13, and I'll meet you at the end of row 23. All right, so I'm at the end of row 23, and I measured this on Niaja's head. And speaking of Niaja, she's doing a very good job at holding the camera pretty still. So thank you, mini me. All right, so finishing up the last row here. One, two. Now, I'm not going to change rows this time. Okay, I'm just going to leave it as is for my last row. Slip. And I'm going to chain one to fasten off. And pull through. Okay, so I'm done. So here's the hat here. It's rounded out and everything. So now I want to add my elastic. So I already have my elastic threaded, so I'd have to go through that. So I'm just going to find a place to start weaving in my elastic. So I'm just going to be weaving it in through the back loop like so. And I believe I already have this part down in another video. I'm not quite sure. So if not, I just weave it through the back loop just like this. Okay. Then I kind of pull it through some. Then I just weave it through some more. And so I'm just going to continue doing this all the way around. So I'll meet you at the end once I got the elastic in. Okay, so I tied my elastic off and I still have my second color still tagged on. So what we're going to do now, I dropped down my hook size to a G to do the foundation row. And I also have this in a video already. But here's the tail at the end of the row, and I'm going to connect these two together to do my foundation row to get it ready for my brim. So I'm going to start here. I'm just going to stick my hook in the stitch right before I slip stitched, and I'm going to slip both colors through like so. Okay? And then I'm going to chain one. All right, and I have the tails of my purple and the end of the hat row here. So now I'm just going to single crochet over the tail of the purple and my elastic all together. Let me get that under there. Okay, so I'm just going to single crochet over the elastic and the tail, which is here. So we're going to go over them. Oops. Do that part over. Go under. Sorry, you guys, my phone going off. single crochet, going over the elastic here and over my tail piece here. So I'm just going to continue doing this. And if at row 23, if that's not long enough, then you go as many rows you need to go until you get like right above the ear. Okay. So I measured this on Nyasia's head, and I think it was a little bit longer. Nyasia has a really small head, so it was a little bit big on her. So I knew that this was perfect. All right. So you're just going to keep doing the single crochet, going all the way around using both colors here and dropping down your hook size one size down. So if you're using an I, you'll use an H. If you're using a J, you'll use an I to do this row here. All right, so continue doing that and I'll meet you at the end. Okay, so I'm coming up to my last two single crochets. All right, and there go the phone again. Sorry, you guys. So I'm gonna slip stitch. I'm going to chain one, pull out enough to weave through, and cut. Pull it out. I'll weave all that in later. So you have your foundation row here. And so now you want to get ready to do your brim. I have a little bit of elastic sticking out here, so I'll easily slip that. And this is from the tail piece, so I'll weave that in too. So let me show you what your inside will look like. Here's your inside from dropping and picking up your two colors. So this is what it'll look like even if you use three colors. So, and this was the beginning part, which I will weave in at the end. So very few loose edges. So now we want to get ready for our brim. So I usually find my middle end piece here and I kind of match it up with the hat like so to kind of give me an area of where I want my brim. And so my brim is worked in. The first row is 17 stitches across. Okay, so I kind of match up where my middle piece is, put my hook there, and count 8 over on one side and 9 on the other. So we start where the stitch is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 right here. So count again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is where I'm going to start my brim. There. And so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So here's the brim here. And as you can see, from this piece, that is about the middle. So this is where I'm going to start my brim. So you can either drop down to a G hook. I usually do my brims with a G hook. Or you can try it out using a H or I, but I always use a G hook because it makes it a little bit stiffer. That's the key to really having a very stiff brim. Okay, so be right back and we'll start our brim. All right, so ready for your brim. You need two strands to do the brim. I'm using a G hook. So we're going to slip stitch where I'm marked. Okay, so I'm going to chain one. That is considered one single crochet. So I'm going to go one single crochet, one single crochet as I'm crocheting over my tail, and then double in the next. One, two. And then you go one single crochet, and then one single crochet, and then double in the next. One, two. You want to keep doing that across the 17 stitches. So you want to count as you go, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4, because that's double, 5, 6, 7, 8. You want to go all the way until you reach 22. So we have 8. And then single, 9, single, which is 10, and then double, which would be 11 and 12. Okay, then single, 13, then single, 14, and then double, 15, 16. All right, and then single, 17, and then single, 18, and then double, 19, and then 20, and then single, single, which would be 21 and 22. So that is 17 stitches across. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And you will count it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. All right, and that is round or row 1. All right, so for row 2, you're going to chain 1. And turn your work around. And so now for round 2, you're going to be working through the back loops only, okay? And from the second stitch from the hook, which is 1, 2, you want to go through the back loop and do a single crochet, making sure your tension is really tight. That's another key thing of a stiff brim. Your tension must be really tight. Okay, so you're just going to work in the back loop only. So continue this till you get to the last stitch, and I'll meet you there. Okay, so ending round 2 of the brim, we have 2 stitches left. I'm going to go ahead and do those in the back loop. Okay, so now the next step here is you are going to do a half double crochet in the unfinished stitch here, as you can see, of the hat. Do a half double crochet. Okay, and now what you're going to do, you're going to turn your work around. You're not going to do any chain. You're going to take your hook. This is the part that really people had a problem with. Take your hook out, go to the next unused stitch, stick your hook through there, and grab your 2 yarns and pull it through. All right, just like that. All right. And then you're going to chain 1. And then you're just going to work a single crochet going all the way across, starting at the very next stitch. So you're just going to do a single crochet, making sure your tension is still really tight. Okay? So keep going a single crochet all the way across, and I'll meet you at the end. Okay, ending row 3, we just have a couple of more stitches left. Holding my tension tight, doing a single crochet, probably holding it too tight. Single crochet in each stitch. Now I'm in my last one here, if I can get it in there. Okay, so now what you want to do is you want to do a half double crochet into this stitch here. If you go all the way down to the hat, the part of the hat here, go into the same stitch.
The focus. Focus.
Is it there?
No. Hold on. Oh my gosh.
Okay. Don't zoom in.
Okay.
Okay, this stitch right here. It's an already worked stitch from the very first row. You're going to do a half double crochet into that stitch there. Okay? And now you're going to do a slip stitch in the next stitch over to the left. And now you're going to turn your yarn around, turn your project around, keeping the yarn to the back. Take your hook out, go into the next stitch here, and grab those 2 yarns and pull it through like so. All right, so now you're going to chain 1 and you're ready for row 4, which is the increase round. So you're going to do a single crochet into that first stitch there, a single crochet into the next 3 stitches, 1, 2, 3, for a total of 4 single crochets. And now you're going to do an increase, 1, 2, single crochet in the next 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, double in the next. 1, 2. So keep doing a single crochet in the next 4 stitches and then double in the next, and I'll meet you when you get to the last few stitches. Okay, so I have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stitches left. Okay, so I just did an increase here. So I'm going to do 1 stitch and then I'm going to do another increase. Okay, so you're going to go 1, 2. All right. And then you, for the next 1, 2, 3 stitches, you're going to do a single crochet. Oops. And 3. Okay. So now you're going to do a half double crochet back down the foundation. You're going to do 1 slip stitch in the next. Turn your work around. Take your hook out, making sure your yarn is to the back. Go into the very next stitch and grab those 2 yarns and pull through. Now this is the very last row of your brim. Okay, so you're going to chain 1. This is round row 5. You're going to do a single crochet in the next stitch. And then you're going to do a single crochet in each stitch going around, so, or going to the other end. So continue that and I'll meet you at the end. Okay, so we have the last 2 stitches left. So what you're going to do here is you're just going to do a slip stitch into this stitch right here. Do a slip. Alright, so if this is how wide you want your brim, you leave as is, you would chain off and weave in. But we're going to make this a little bit wider. So you're just going to chain 1, turn your work around, and you're going to go in that very next stitch and do a single crochet. That's 1, 2. We're going to go 1 more. And then you're going to increase 1, 2. So you're going to increase every 3. 1, 2. And then the third one, increase. 1, 2. And do it again. 1, 2. And then increase. 1, 2. So continue that and I'll meet you at the end. Okay, so I just increased there. You should have about 2 to 3 stitches left. I have 2. All right. So this is how it should look. So you're going to do a slip stitch, or basically no, you're going to turn it around like you always did, turn it around, go into the next stitch, oops, and pull it through, just like so. And now you're just going to do a chain 1 and single crochet into the next stitch, and then continue it going all the way to the other end. So continue doing that, and I'll meet you at the end. All right, coming to the end. Next stitch, okay. So now you're just going to do a slip stitch in the very next stitch of the hat. Slip it, chain 1, pull out, and we're gonna cut and pull through, and then that's when you're gonna weave in. So here's your brim, and to kind of match it to make sure that it is the same on each side, I fold it in half evenly. And as you can see, it has that curve, so it's done evenly. So what you do is just weave it in, and what I do is I take it right through here and weave it in through the back. And then you are complete with your hat.
Hey everybody, welcome back. And so here is the hat here with the brim. Hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. As you can see with the changing of the colors, how you cannot see a shift at all from changing. There is a kind of a line, but pretty much that's how it looks from the back. Hopefully I didn't go too fast. I'm sort of used to doing these hats, so I tend to go fast. I did an extra row for the brim so you can see if you want your brim to stick out further. And as you can see, it is really stiff. So, yeah, I really like how this hat turned out. I'm kind of liking it for myself, you know. So, this hat is unisex. Like I said, you can do these in male colors. I've did a few for my husband. I think a black and red and a black and gray striped hat. And really like how it turned out. I will be doing another hat probably today, similar. Probably using the same colors but different stitches. So, yeah. So, there is the hat there. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. As far as the written pattern, I really don't have this written down. It's kind of like in here. So feel free to write down the pattern by following the tutorial. And hey, you can email it to me. I'd love to have it. That way, if anybody emails me or send me a message, I can send it to them. So here is the result of the striped brimmed cap for Tutorial Tuesday. I think this is 27. All right, so thanks for following along. And like I said, hope you enjoyed the tutorial. I'll give you guys like a 360. And my cat is like pulling me right now. Like, give me attention. Tyson, no. So turn it all the way around so you can see here. So I hope this helped you out as far as changing the colors. So until the next video, remember to keep God first in your life and everything else secondary. Bye. Proverbs chapter 4 verses 5 through 7. Get wisdom, get understanding, forget it not, neither decline from the words of my mouth. Forsake her not, and she shall preserve thee. Love her, and she shall keep thee. Wisdom is a principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. God bless you guys.